Hey guys, Hobbs here. Brewfest is over, so other than coming here and summoning this band with your remote that you got during Brewfest, what can you do? Well, you can talk to this mistress here. She's going to give you a quest called the Love Potion. It's going to enable you to open the door so you can go further in if you're doing power leveling or other runs. Head to this zone here. You have to kill 10 of these guys. Well, not 10. Some of them drop 2 of these silver veins. Then once that's done, I headed down to Scythius, because I don't think Ungoro has a flight path, and I went to this point here, this little lake, and you have to fill this vial at this point here as well. Now, you did have to collect some Groom's Blood, which is a herbalism quest. I checked the auction house for a few days, couldn't find it, so I had a friend of mine herb it for me in... where is it? The Siren Gorge. So once that's done, hand in all the items to her, and now it's like having the key, because every time you talk to her, she's going to go and talk to this guy, and they're going to have some time alone. The main thing is they open the door on their way. So I have a timer in the top right-hand corner. I've got a bunch of lower levels with me. I'm the only 80. And the thing I want to do is find out how fast I can do this, and will they get any experience. The first boss you can do, hit those 3 crates, and there's their first blue of the day, bind on pickup. Basically, I had the loot rules set up. Roll need if you need it. Roll pass if you don't, and I would greed on things. Now, we talked to her, and this is a point where she opens up the door for you. On your left, you see a little gnome there. If you're a rogue, you can pickpocket that gnome, get the key, and open this door and avoid that whole first quest line, first part of this video. So now this is a point, obviously, I'm letting them know, stay back, you know, only come close once I got them rounded up and I click on the little mini map, which I did there. That way they get experience and they can loot up as we move on to the second boss of the day, which is right here. And it's already only 4 minutes in. We were standing in Stormwind just not long ago, and we're already into the second boss. So it's quite a fast instance. I have covered this full instance before, but not to this degree where it's just a fast power leveling run right to the end. The other thing too is that this room, I find you have to pull them in smaller packs because they do path back. They are programmed to not follow you forever. So, and then as you see, I'm pulling them around the corner to line of sight the casters. So that room, unfortunately, you can't do it as large as you would like, but you can still do a pretty good pull. This room, I'm going to skip by a few of the bosses because there's like 6 or 7 of them in here. You talk to this guy, you down them each one at a time because they summon one at a time. You get a nice little chest that they can get some BOP loot again. Summons right there by the door. Now, going through this door, you can turn right and actually go to Molten Core. When we were doing the Brewfest boss, we took 480s and downed the boss, so it's quite easy. We snaked through and avoided most of the mobs, killed the optional boss along the way. 2 people got the achievement this run. You could probably do it less. I wasn't really doing this to say, hey, look at me, I can do this Ragnaros with 4 people. Well, no, but at the same time, it's another option for power leveling. But back to Blackrock Depths. This is the most annoying part of the whole run, and I tried to make it as least annoying as possible. Lots of mobs, which looks like, hey, great experience, great opportunity for, you know, giving these guys lots of experience, possibly getting loot. But unfortunately, all these spawns in here, they just respawn over and over again. They don't drop any loot, and they don't give any experience. Well, if they do, it's like it's very, very minor. Not worth farming for experience. What I am looking for are these short little dwarves within the packs that are going to give me the ability to light these 2 torches at the end hall. Now here you see we lost a couple people. I do have this video sped up, by the way, but you'll see how annoying it gets. By the time I'm going to res, they've respawned. We try again and again and again. So when I went back and did this again, what I did was I made sure they were all stood back there. I lit the 2 torches, then I pathed them through. That way, if they aggroed, we killed them off, and we didn't go through this. As you see, we're still trying to res, and if we rewind it, it's got to be a few minutes. Like, we're only 13 minutes into the dungeon, and we've wasted about 5 minutes on this room alone. So, and we're not done yet. I'll tell you, there was one run I did. I didn't record it, but there was this one guy, and he had that healer thing where if something was on him, he would run. So I'm trying to pull it off them, and, you know, he's not healing himself. He's just running around, and he's pulling more of the mobs. Like, finally, I had to say, just stand there, you know, either that way I can pull them off of him, and two, he can not end up pulling more mobs where he would have lived if he hadn't have been panicking and running around. That's really an old school new thing for healers in general is, you know, don't run away from your tank. If anything, run to the tank if you're in trouble. Jump into that consecration, have it pull it off you. So we're getting to the last room, and we did have a couple wipe here, but we did have one ding. So the great thing with this last room is it's a lot like the last boss in Scarlet Monastery. You aggro the boss, and you aggro everything in the room, which makes it really, it's a nice time saver. Obviously, you pull them around the corner for line of sight, and I've slowed this down so that you can see it in real time. I flew through this today, guys. I'm going to leave on my blog everything that dropped. The link is on the right. The other thing I'm going to do is I'm going to put the last 2 years of the Hallow's End video, because really all that has changed is the bosses went to 80, but I'll show you at the end here, he is still quite easy. The other thing too, a lot of the items have increased, so I've been passing on things because I already have the helm dropped today, the sword, the horseman sword, it's a better sword, but really all I want the sword for is, you know, to produce the fun effect where it summons all the little ads, the little pumpkin ads. And then lastly, the only thing I'm going for this year is the mount, the flying headless horseman mount. So, you know, it's a similar to the Brewfest, which just passed, where you can do that boss 5 times a day. You'll see a few people got the achievement here on this run that we just did. One of the nice satisfactions, I think, of finishing this instance is to be able to sit in the throne, because it's definitely a really good screenshot. And now on to Hallow's End this year. If you look at my last 2 years of videos, I pretty well cleared everything, you know, sort of covered everything. Most of the quests to get the achievement are pretty self-explanatory, except for one. One quest you need to do first. I didn't do it till the end of last year because, you know, the one quest where you have to obtain all the masks, you don't need that to get the Hallow's End achievement, like to complete the whole thing. They took that away, but by the point time that I thought it was achievable, it was the last day, and none of the Horde were dropping these little stink bombs here, so I had to wait till this year to get it. I had one quest, day one, was able to finish the Hallow's End achievement, get that tied up. So if anything, guys, make sure you do that one first, and the other one when you're heading on your way to Scarlet Monastery, if you're Alliance, you want to interrupt the Horde ones. Which one? It will help you get the quest. Two, for Horde, it will help them finish their quest. So it's a symbiotic quest where you need them to do it and you need to complete it as well. This is this year's Headless Horseman event. I was surprised that he's level 80 epic. I was surprised at how fast we did down him. But the main thing is, you know, let's just get it done, get it over, get your 5 saves, see what drops, hope for the mount. Guys, make sure you hit the subscribe button because I will have more coming out in the future. That's my remote video. Till next time.